Well, this is an introduction and taster sort of overview video for a series of videos I have planned showing people how to get good sound from CD, or perhaps more precisely how I get good sound from CD on my system. Now it will cover things that target the discs directly, and it will also cover equipment and what equipment to look for and what equipment to buy, and also how to set up the equipment correctly and to best advantage, and tailor the equipment and the setup to create the sound that you want. Different people like different sort of approach to sound, and by doing different things you can alter the way the sound is presented. But here I show my 5-stage CD treatment process that absolutely all my new CDs that enter my inbox go through before I even listen to them. Absolutely every single disc gets treated in this manner first, because it makes a huge difference. This video will probably create more questions than it actually answers, but it's just a quick overview of what you can expect from the series, which will drop over the coming year. So let's get on with this video. To do it, I need some CDs. So these are my new CDs that I haven't listened to yet, that need to be put through the treatment process. Now these first 5 are the ones I got for Christmas. Got Edda, medieval music from Iceland; Mirka, Danish female black metal artist; Angus and Julia Stone, self-titled, Craft Spells and Nausea there; and soundtrack to TV series Viking; and cover mount CD from the magazine Mojo, Best of 2014. Now all those are brand new and sealed, but these are the ones are second hand. Soundtrack to the film Sin City, 99p. Blind Melon, self-titled, also 99p. Madonna, Immaculate Collection, reduced from £1.95 down to £1. They're all from charity shops. Thought I already had this, but it was a CDR masquerading as a proper CD, so now I replaced it with an original. And Rocket Tarore, the Malian artist there, and I bought that second hand on Amazon. It's only about £1.20 or something for a CD, which is in mint condition. I say we live in the glory age of the cheap CD. If you like music, do not overlook buying cheap CDs at the moment, because it will not last. Now, these 10 CDs, mixed from new and second hand, need to go through what I do to treat them, which is a 5-stage treatment process, which I'll briefly show now. And it improves the sound quality of the CD, and improves it quite markedly. I never listen to CDs when I first buy them until they've gone through this 5-step process, and I always wait until I've got at least 10 to actually put through the process. It takes some time. It's actually quicker to clean my vinyl records than it is to put the CDs through this process. As you say, I always wait until I've got at least 10, and do them in batches of 10. It's either 10, 20 or 30 get treated at once. But the difference is quite marked. It removes an awful lot of the digital artifacts and sort of other sort of graininess and problems that you get with the CD sound. I mean, people quite often say to me when I say things like, oh, CD's warmer than vinyl, and people look at me like I'm mad, or leave comments under my videos. In my system, CD is warmer than vinyl. Digital is warmer than vinyl. Yeah, vinyl's got its strength, and warmth isn't one of them. But it depends how you set up your digital equipment. In my opinion, most people have got their digital equipment set up incorrectly. They haven't got it set up for best advantage. And it depends to a large extent on the ancillary components as well. But one of the important things with digital is making sure that the discs are good. If you're still using CDs or Blu-ray audio or Super Audio CD, DVD audio, if you're using discs, you need to keep them in tip-top condition. Now I'm going to show my 5-stage process briefly now. Now the first thing I do is make sure all the cases are in tip-top condition. Now these 3 are second-hand, and as is usual second-hand, and sometimes with new as well, the cases are damaged. This case is very, very dirty and very, very scratched on the back. This case has got a crack in it, and the Madonna case is quite badly smashed. And they just need replacing. You made the choice to buy physical products. You may as well look after the physical product and cherish it, even if they are very, very cheap to buy. And just put them in brand new dual cases, no big deal. And just keep everything tip-top. And there they are, in their brand new cases, ready to enter the treatment process with the other new CDs. Now, first thing I use in the treatment process of the CDs is simply CD cleaners. They're just dead simple 100 pack of cleaning wipes. And so I won't clean this in here. I'll take it into the bathroom and show how it's done. So here we have the little cleaning wipes, just rip one off there. Now this is very dry, needs to have additional moisture. Add to it. Now we always add some extra soap. To be honest, any old sort of hand soap will do. And get that lovely and wet. You want it really, really wet for doing this, not dry at all, absolutely soaking. And you then just rub it on here. Now people will always say you need to clean from the inside out. If the CD is dirty, that is true. If the CD is already perfectly clean, frankly, you can do it like that. It doesn't matter. It's only going to scratch if there's dirt on there. Keep this very, very wet. Always clean the inside, and always clean the outside here too. And I say, if it's a second-hand CD, I always clean the outside of the label as well. But just make sure it's thoroughly, thoroughly clean. And once you've cleaned it, straight under the tap, rinse off absolutely all of that detergent. And that is the basic cleaning of the CD. Now we have stage two of the cleaning process. This is my CD cleaning machine. It is an ultrasonic cleaner. I believe they're originally designed for cleaning jewellery. But I use them to clean CDs. Now if you're going to get one for cleaning CDs, make sure it comes with an adapter for actually putting CDs onto it. So here I'm going to put the Mojo cover mount CD and the Sin City CD. This one can take two at the same time. And you just drop them in. Now this has got water in it. And you just drop them in as so. Put the lid on. Set the time. And off you go. Now the ultrasonic cleaner vibrates the water at a very, very high frequency. And any dirt that's on there just falls off. It is by far and away the very best way of cleaning CDs that I've ever found. There's no actual physical contact with the disc itself, of course, there's no scratches or anything. And very, very efficient. And as I say, it gets it cleaner than it would be possible to get it in any other way. Now we need to dry the CDs. So just take the CD out, drain as much water off it as possible. And then just simply dry it with a paper towel. And you may need to use multiple paper towels. Now I'd advise only using white towels, don't use ones with patterns on, as sometimes the pattern actually runs. And just very, very gently dab it off. And as I say, if one towel gets wet, you just get another one. You will go through paper towels like there's no tomorrow. But it's worth it so that you don't scratch your CD in again. This should not scratch the CD in any shape or form. And this is secondhand, it's got a few scratches on it. Anyway, but I can feel, just rubbing that the surface of this is literally squeaky clean. Obviously, I don't want to put fingerprints on it. But, and that's it. The CD is now dry and as clean as you're ever going to get it. Now we have stage three of the CD treatment process. Now this is what's known as an optical disc finalizer. This is a very esoteric audiophile product from Japan. And it's very expensive, but in the context of a large CD collection, as I have, it was worth the investment. And it also treats DVDs and Blu-ray videos as well as audio discs. Now, so what does it do? Well, it looks like a little tiny personal CD player. It basically works in a similar way. You get your disc, in this case the Sin City disc that we've already cleaned. You put it in, close it up, switch the thing on, then decide how many flashes of light you wish to give the disc. And that's it. The disc spins round and round, which is what you can hear now. And it is being flashed with very high intensity light. What this does is alters the physical properties of the plastic, makes the disc easy to read by the laser in the CD player, and in doing so reduces the error correction and improves the sound quality. It's a strange device. It's not something I advise people rush out and buy, but I'm showing you what I do with my equipment. And as I say, this will be featured in a video. In fact, all the things that I do to improve the quality of CD will be featured in a series of videos, and I've got 13 separate topics lined up, each of which will have their own dedicated video. And that's it. It is now treated. Now I also treat the other side as well. And off it goes. here we have the fourth stage of the CD treatment process. So we get the CD and put it into the device, switch it on, and get it going. Now this is another audiophile product from Japan, made by the company Furotech, and it is a disc demagnetizer. It demagnetizes the CD. Now, unlike the optical finalizer, this isn't permanent. You need to do this about every 10 or 20 plays of the CD. You need to demagnetize it again. Although the CD is made of aluminium, it can have ferrous compounds in it, and quite often the print on the label will have ferrous compounds, particularly blacks and reds. And the disc can get magnetized, and spinning round and round and round creates huge magnetic fields in the CD player. It doesn't do the electronics in the CD player any favors whatsoever. Demagnetizing it just makes the CD sound that much clearer, that much more precise. And that's it. It saved you both sides. And yeah, the disc is done. Right, here we are at stage 5 of the CD treatment process, and very, very simple stage this time, just anti-static spray. Put some anti-static spray onto a cloth and then get your CD, and again I'm going to use the sensitivity, and you clean the label side. You don't clean the playing side, you clean the label side with the anti-static spray, and that's it. Cleans the disc, which is nice, but it also removes a static build-up, and it'll last maybe 10 plays or something like that, and you need to do it again. It's like the demagnetizing, it's not permanent. So you need to keep doing it. And that is the final stage in the CD treatment process. So this is my 5-stage disc treatment process that all the CDs that I own have gone through. All the CDs that I buy go through. In fact, all the DVD and Blu-ray videos I buy also go through this. Even computer games will end up going through this process. Now, again, it is my process. So why do I do it? How does it work? Well, first of all, we'll recap. Cleaning, basic cleaning with the wipes. Everybody should be doing that with their CDs. Ultrasonic cleaner to give a really deep clean. Again, if you're into CDs big time, get yourself one of these. They're not expensive. I think that was about £45, something like that. And it's the second one I've owned, but the first one probably did 5,000 discs before it gave up the ghost, and this one's still going, so pretty good. Optical finalizer. Now, this is a very audiophile piece of equipment. I'm not sure it's even still available or not, but it's, as I say, it's a very esoteric thing from Japan, and it's expensive. Can't remember what I paid for it, but it's about £600. It's not cheap, but in the context of discs, and I've got over 8,000 digital discs, worth every penny. Then you've got the demagnetizer. Again, it's another audiophile product, and again, they're not cheap. I think I paid about £250, something like that, but they're a lot more expensive than that now. And again, it's something that I use, and if you're very serious about CD and you've got high-end kit, worth buying. Then there's the anti-static spray. Again, dirt cheap. Yeah, bought that from Apple. It's for about £5. Everybody should be using anti-static spray on the label side of these CDs. So, you know, everybody should be cleaning. Everybody should be using anti-static. If you're serious about your CDs, you want to be going onto that. If you want to invest in some of the audiophile type tweakery, go for it. Now, this isn't all the processes that I put CDs through. There are others as well, but these are the main 5. Now, I tend to have a series of videos for CDs, and I've already got 13 topics lined up to how to get the very best sound from your CDs. Some of which will be the discs themselves, how to improve them, as we've shown here. Others will be how to improve your CD player and what CD players to choose, and other ways of doing it as well, like switching your CDs to computer audio. So, how does it work? Put very simply, less error correction reduces problems with magnetism, reduces problems with static. It's that simple. Each step improves the sound quality of CD. Error correction makes CD sound very harsh, slightly wrong, slightly artificial, slightly clinical. And if you can remove it, all well and good. Now, cleaning isn't permanent. You can do it first of all, but you will need to clean the things again. The optical finalizer is permanent. In fact, if you keep doing it, you will actually destroy the CD. So it is a one-off thing, but the effect is permanent. Demagnetizing, again, it's not permanent. 10 plays, maybe 20 before it needs to be done again. And then the anti-static spray again, maybe about 10 plays before you need to reapply it. Now, cleaning it can have a monumental effect on the sound quality. Just using that, huge. And as I say, this just takes it another step further forward. This has a very obvious effect on the sound, and you can A/B test the difference between the discs every time, and you will get it right every time. You don't need special ears to tell the difference. It just removes some of the sort of digital artifacts, digital problems you get with CDs. It makes them sound more real, more analogue. Same with this. In fact, both have a very similar effect, but they work together and the cumulative effect to actually be better still. And the anti-static spray again has a very noticeable effect on the sound. Now, I will go into all these things in much more detail in future, but the end result is I never ever listen to a CD before it has been put through these five stages, because without putting through these five stages, the CD sounds bad, and I don't care whether it's new or second hand, it does not sound good enough to listen to until it has been treated. It's very important to look at your hi-fi holistically. It's not just a separate thing, like, oh, I've got a good CD player, job done, I've got a good CD. It doesn't work like that. You have to set the CD player up correctly, you have to treat the CDs well if you want the best sound, and the CD player has to match your amplification and speakers very well as well. You need to look at everything holistically and do everything you can to make everything as good as possible. Of course, after all that time and effort treating the CDs, there is only one thing to do, and that is actually play them. Put the disc in the player. And enjoy.